your robot uses a tool that is potentially dangerous, you can lower the risk of accidents by restricting the angle in which the tool is allowed to point. For example, by making sure that a sharp tool always points downwards. To restrict the tool direction, go to the Safety menu and select Tool Direction. Here you can define a cone and the degrees the tool is allowed to deviate within the cone. To define the cone, start by creating a feature. The positive Z direction of the feature defines the cone direction. In this example, the tool is pointing downwards in the application, so I create a point feature that has the positive Z axis pointing downwards. The feature is only used to indicate the cone direction, and its position in space has no influence on the restriction applied to the tool direction. In the Tool Direction menu, you can now use the point feature to define the cone. The arrow from the tool flange indicates the default tool direction, and the sphere indicates the area the tool is allowed to move in. In the Restrictions menu, you can select which restrictions to apply. When Normal is selected, the limit is applied when the robot is running in normal mode. Reduced applies the limit only in reduced mode. And when both is selected, the limit is applied in both modes. In the deviation field, you adjust the size of the cone. A deviation of 90 degrees prevents the tool direction from rotating more than 90 degrees away from the Z-axis of the chosen feature. In this example, I want to restrict the tool even more, so I reduce the deviation to 30 degrees, which results in a much smaller cone. In the tool properties, you can define the direction the tool is pointing. If tool flange is selected, the direction is set to the Z-axis of the tool output flange. If TCP is selected, the direction of the selected TCP feature is used. The cone moves along with the tool flange, so the robot is able to perform the task, but restricted from deviating outside of the cone. As always, you can manually test this safety setting by moving the robot around in free drive. Now let's look at an example where the TCP direction is not aligned with the tool flange Z-axis. I'll use the same feature to define the cone direction. Now the default tool direction is not aligned with the actual direction of the tool, and it is positioned outside the cone. In Tool Properties, you can select a TCP. The tool direction will then be aligned with the direction of the Z-axis of the TCP. You can also edit the tool direction manually. In Tilt, you can tilt the direction towards the X-axis of the tool flange. And in Pan, you can rotate the direction around the Z-axis of the tool flange. If your TCP is correctly set, using it as tool direction is the best approach in most cases.